Now, you know, as a librarian, I did some research, and I understand that there's a library. You actually worked in a library bindery?
Oh, yes. I worked in a book bindery one summer, Bob Goldman's book bindery. I did. It was the summer right before I went to college. I had a friend's mother who worked there, and it was my first real job. Before then, I did the neighborhood jobs, babysitting. I had a family next to us that they paid me to do everything for them. Babysit, train a dog, tutor piano. The Smiths, I love them. They got me through high school. But then I graduated to a job downtown. The bindery was downtown, and a friend's mother worked there. And my job it entailed doing one thing 1,000 times every day, all day, over and over again. So I got to put the little metal thing in a hole and then pass the cardboard over to the guy that would slam it down. So my job was to take the metal thing, put it in the hole, and pass it. And I was good with doing that for the first day, even. I thought, you know, yeah. I was aiming at finishing it. I thought there would be an end to it, that there were like thousands of them, and I would prove to the bindery people that I was so fast that I could complete it and I would be done. And I just realized it's never over. They just kept coming. The little pieces of cardboard and the little things, and that went on for weeks and weeks and weeks doing the same thing. And I just thought, my God, I'm ready for college. I can do this. But it taught me great respect for the men and women who do that work every day, that thankless work that makes it possible for us to have books and folders. And, you know, I learned work ethic at the bindery. The dozens of people in that plant who came there and they did the same job every day for years and years and years,
right.
You know. They reminded me of my father, those blue-collar workers who didn't look for passion in their jobs. They didn't have the luxury like we did to think about doing the things that we loved. They had to do things that put food on the table. And that was my first experience, shoulder to shoulder, with men and women who were making a living for their families.